We are set to crown champions from the city of Four Lakes, Madison, Wisconsin. We're deciding the fittest on earth at the 2018 Reebok CrossFit Games. Welcome inside the Age Group Pavilion at Alliant Energy Center. It's the Teenage Girls Division, event number 11, Complex Fran. With Jeremy Austin, Joel Godet, glad to have you along with us. Nikki Brazier down on the floor. Complex Fran, Jeremy, is what it sounds like. It's Fran with a twist.
You don't want to make it any more complex than what it is. But for time, we've got 7 bar muscle ups, 7 chest to bars, and 7 pull ups. So it's going to constitute the 21 pulling movements, 21 thrusters. Then we do the 5, 5, and 5, and 15 thrusters, the 3s, and the 9 thrusters. And they are going to be doing it at Fran weight, which is 95 pounds for the guys coming up later on, and 65 pounds for the ladies who are attacking the floor right now. 7 minutes to get the work done.
Wouldn't be the CrossFit Games without a 21-15-9. Haley Adams in lane 10. All eyes on the first place leader. Kayla Stefano, the two-time defending champion, will be directly to her left in lane 11. Stefano beating Adams each of the last 2 years by 26 combined points. Adams here in 2018, not being denied. She has won 9 of the 10 events so far and is in line, if she closes it out, to have the greatest single individual performance in CrossFit Games history.
Now, this is going to be really quick, so blink and you're going to miss it. Now, the complex. A number of athletes are going to go unbroken from the muscle up straight into the chest to bar and then straight into the pull-ups. Adam's choosing to not do that. Now, if you want to hurt or have to hurt, now is the time to do it. If you've done Fran before in your life, which many CrossFitters have done, it is not a pleasant workout to do. Now, coming in and making it a little bit harder with those high-skill gymnastic movement, like the bar muscle up first and then the chest to bar, just makes that grip strength a whole lot worse. Keep in mind, we're doing it in the reverse order that Fran normally is, so the thrusters are last.
Kayla Stefano was the first to the barbell. The lone event that Haley Adams has not won this week was the 500-meter open water swim. Kayla Stefano won it. And Kayla Stefano is a champion in her own right. Listen, Haley Adams is not here this week without Kayla Stefano. It was the motivation of the defeats to the young lady on the left that pushed Haley Adams. She changed her training this year. She worked with Chris Hinshaw on her endurance, personalized coaching. She has taken a new approach. Stefano was pushing her again here in event 11.
Now, Kayla Stefano went unbroken on the first set, the 7 muscle up, chest to bar, and also the pull-up. She's now starting to fatigue a little. Now, has Haley Adams' strategy coming in breaking up those 7 bar muscle-ups before she does the 7 chest to bar and 7 pull-up going to work in her favor? It's only 5s now, so 5 bar muscle-up, 5 chest to bars, and 5 pull-ups, but we know Stefano is so quick on the pull-up movement.
This is a 7-minute event, a sprint event. Jeremy, if you know anything about sprints?
Yes, I do.
Anything can happen.
That's exactly right. Stefano with that beautiful sweeping butterfly pull-up movement for both chest to bar and the pull-up. It was very hard to take notice of when she did transition from the chest to bar down to the pull-up, but she did the 10 reps straight, but now into the 15 thrusters. And lots of hip drive required here. The hips and the legs are absolutely smoked from the last 10 events that have gone on. And they've got to try and engage that core and use those hips as much as possible. Get that barbell propelled over the head.
Stefano advancing that barbell. She is on now to her final round of Complex Fran.
The bar muscle up has proven to be difficult on the fives. I wouldn't be surprised to see Kayla Stefano do single reps here. Resting a little bit at the top, but she does not want to fail a rep. But Stefano, getting them done.
Onto the chest to bar for Stefano. Adams onto the muscle ups on your right side of the screen. Adams came in with a 234-point lead. Those are the largest margins of victory in any division in CrossFit Games history. Matt Frazier is the fittest ever. Two-time defending champion. He looks like he's going to take the crown in 2018, and she is blowing his lead out of the water from a year ago. Now, if Stefano can beat her here, she will close that gap. Stefano will pick up the event win, but if Adams can close behind her, it will be a historic performance. Hand is up. Haley Adams. Stefano pushed her all the way. She was nearly perfect. Haley Adams isn't just the fittest on earth. She's the fittest teen in history.
Absolutely outstanding performance from the young lady who has dominated the field, and the emotion starting to flow. It's been a big week.
Stefano, the event win in 3:59. Adams in 4:19 unofficially. There's a difference in 10 points there. As Faith Ferguson finishes through her thrusters, Adams' margin of victory will go down as the largest single margin of victory by an individual, masters, teen, or team in CrossFit Games lore. Chloe Smith fighting for a podium here. Entered the event in third place, the champion from a year ago as a 15-year-old. Over the bar, and Smith in the clubhouse. That is an 11th place for Smith. Only 28 points. Devin Kim came in third. We'll have to watch how the back end of the podium squares up. 6 minutes into our 7-minute time cap, Jeremy.
That was so fast.
What we just witnessed over the last 5 days has been incredible.
And I know Matt Fraser's done amazing things with the individual competition. We've not seen that dominance in the teenage division in the years that it has been here at the CrossFit Games. Wow.
Haley Adams finished 11th in the Atlantic Regional as well, as we have now 30 seconds left in the event.
Do you put a wager on for her to come here next year as an individual?
Her goal is that. It's never happened. No teen has made the jump the next year to the open division at the Games. As Tessa Marquette, the Floridian, trying to beat the time cap here with 10 seconds. Haley Adams might be the one. The enigma. Marquette finishes. Kayla Stefano closes on a high note, an event win for the two-time defending champion. Nothing to sneeze at. Stefano will be on the podium this year. Phenomenal performance by her. She just ran into a buzzsaw in Haley Adams. This was an awesome weekend in this division.
Stefano so quick with that butterfly chest bar, butterfly pull-up, resting a little, if you can call it a rest, onto the thrusters. But it was, once she got out in front, the smaller stature and that fast cycle rate of those pull-ups made sure she stayed out in front, but she battled all the way, but she just couldn't get there this year. The former champ winning in event number 11.
Everyone knows Matt Fraser's name. They will soon know Haley Adams. She comes in second in the event, but most importantly, she comes in first in the Games. She's down with Nikki.
What a whirlwind of a week. Near perfect record. A little bit emotional. What are you thinking right now?
The past 2 years, it's been really hard to take it. But this is just shows me that was the small picture, and this is the big picture, and I'm just so blessed.
been working so hard. We've actually never seen a teenage division competitor age out and then qualify for games, but is that a goal for you?
I will be at the games next year.
Congratulations on your big victory.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, Nikki. Congratulations, Haley. Jeremy, I got to be honest, too. This has been a week of people calling their shots and hitting the target. That's the final shot called. And I'm not going to be surprised at all if you and I are standing back here in 2019 and she nailed that target.
Absolutely. And I am going to put a wager on right now if she has just said that. She has been so dominant, not just in a few events, every event. There wasn't a movement, there wasn't a rep scheme, there wasn't a time domain that was outside of Haley Adams's realm. She nailed everything.
She won 9 of the 11 events at this competition. The all-time career record for wins in the teenage division. Not a single year, but career was 9. Haley Adams puts up the most dominant performance we have ever seen from one person. And it's just getting started.
That is probably the scariest thing ever, is a few different odd objects this year, different movements this year, but she's obviously done her homework with all of that training to ensure there were no holes, because she mentioned in the interview the last 2 years has been quite difficult to come in second place to Kayla Stefano, but she wasn't going to let that stop her this year.
Dream big. Young ladies across the world, Haley Adams saying, hey, it never occurred to me that girls shouldn't have muscles. She flexed them this week, big time.
Any new news to her with 1,080 points, your 2018 Reebok CrossFit Games champ in the 16-17-year-old female division, Haley Adams. What a dynamite performance here all week long. Make sure you come back here and support all your athletes later on this afternoon at our awards ceremony. But don't go anywhere. Competition here in just about 5 minutes.
Zach Mayer. Ladies of morning, Alejandro Arizona. Currently in fifth place, 512 points.
Inside the age group pavilion at the Alliant Energy Center, it's the teenage boys 16 and 17 division, the final event. Event number 11. It's an oldie, but a goodie with a twist. Complex Fran, Jeremy Alston, Joel Gaudette, Nicky Brazier down in the field. Glad to have you along with us. Complex Fran with a twist of what?
21-15, 9 thrusters and pull-ups. We're throwing a bit of a change. We've got bar muscle-ups, chester bar pull-ups, and then normal pull-ups. Sevens in the first round, five in the second, and three in the third. These gentlemen, 95 pounds, or about 42 and a half kilos, 7 minutes, my normal Fran time, but these guys are going to do it in about half that.
Dahlin Pepper was in fifth place after day one, and he has been in first place ever since. He is in lane 10. Noah Casey was your day one leader. He is still in the podium hunt. Fifth place overall right now, occupying lane 7. Dylan Cade is a guy to keep an eye on. Down in lane 17, the lone Irishman, Tyg Lawless, has had himself a good back end of the weekend, too, after a tougher start. Dahlin Pepper, eyes on the prize, back-to-back crowns.
What a beast already. He did call his shot. He didn't have a great start coming in fifth, but once he said, these events are going to suit me, and they have, but he is going all out for another event win.
Underway for Complex Fran, over 7 minutes of action. You want these guys to go unbroken.
That'd be nice. I can't even go unbroken with Fran normally. So unbroken Complex, the 7-7 and 7. I spoke to Dallin. What he said was he's going to do, he's going to break up the bar muscle up. So he's going to do 7 bar muscle ups first, but then go 7 chest bars and 7 pull ups. He's going to do that for the 3 sets. So when he gets into the 5s, he'll break at the 5 bar muscle ups and then do the 10 reps and then the 3 and the 6. But he said the thrusters, they're unbroken.
Dahlin Pepper has one more rep. We mentioned Tyg Lawless in the lane assignments. He is actually the first guy to get to the thrusters in this event. Dahlin Pepper, unofficially your champ at this point. When you look at it statistically, he just has to make sure he gets through this event. But the battle for third is the one to keep an eye on. That 8-point difference, Cade overcoming Elwell this morning in event 10.
Who's just left a screen without the shirt on. I had a little bit of trouble with that sandbag a few hours ago. I mentioned on the way into today, it was all his to lose. But he's doing all he can to gain back those crucial points and put himself back in contention for a podium spot.
Elwell walks his way back to the bar. Let's talk about walking back to the bar versus jogging versus running back to the bar. How much of it is catching your breath, and how much of it is how badly do you want it?
If you've done Fran at any stage, I don't know about anyone else, but there's no running anywhere. You need to recover at some point, but also you want to get this event done before that lactic acid buildup is there. Because once it does hit, it does start to slow you down. Now, Elwell and Cade, we know Cade has got a massive engine, and he said events like this were going to really suit him. Now, coming in third position, he can really cement this podium spot. Ramirez in the pink shorts to the left, just ahead of him.
Games champion of 2015 in the teenage division, Vincent Ramirez. Tough start to his weekend. He's come on strong since. A second place finish this morning in event 10, the core couplet.
It's funny that Dahlin Pepper was the last person off the 7 bar muscle up, chest bar pull up, and pull up. He is now level pegging with Vincent Ramirez and trying to chase down Dylan Cade, who is powering on those third and last bar muscle up done. So the strategy breaking them up is working perfectly for all of them. because there hasn't been many no reps yet. Great pull of those hips up to the bar and extend.
Here comes Dylan Cade looking for a podium. Nathan Clifton is already on the thrusters. He could steal 10 points from Cade. Clifton came in sixth place. Drops the bar. Nathan Clifton, another event win, his second of the games. Now Cade has fought through knee issues. He's mastered it. And Dallin Pepper closes his coronation. Elwell finishes behind him. Sixth place for Elwell. Fourth for Pepper. Vincent Ramirez in seventh. Dylan Cade with the second place finish. May very well have put himself on the podium. Seven-minute time cap here. Still a little bit of work to go. Dylan Cade torn meniscus in his knee in 2016, in August of 2017, again during the online qualifier. Not sure what he's going to do about it after the games, but he felt okay. That's an understatement. Dylan Cade accomplished what he came here to do. So did the man in the green top, Dallin Pepper.
Get this air of confidence about these young men and young women coming through these age divisions. And they go, yep, I'm going to do this. And then they follow it up and do it. When I was a teenager, I didn't know what the hell I was doing.
Tyler Anderson conquering the thrusters in the blue.
Dylan Cade, what a way to finish your week. Reebok CrossFit Games.
The podium coming in was Pepper, Ramirez, and Cade. And there's no reason to think we should see much shakeup there. Dallin Pepper, though, has indeed cemented himself a back-to-back CrossFit Games championship.
And Elwell had it all to do to stay in that top three at the start of the day. What a great race it was. All athletes choosing to break up the bar muscle-ups and then continue on with the chest bar and the pull-ups. All athletes using that smooth butterfly pull-up position. But it was the speed of the thrusters that got Clifton over the line, and he accelerated in the threes. And then to the ninth thrusters to finish up, and absolutely pumped. Clifton, what an exceptional performance from him.
Pretty good performance from Dallin Pepper too. And he's a champion with Nikki.
That's right, he is a champion. You said that you set out to prove that even at 16 you can stand on top of that podium, and you did. How did you pull that off this week?
Every day during training, I pictured myself here and with the kids that were out there next to me, and it pushed me that much harder. So.
Now, I know that you've dedicated a lot to CrossFit in the last year, especially sort of leading off other sports, other extracurriculars. Is that how you plan to continue training here?
Yeah, I fell in love with CrossFit when I started it, and I just love it. So.
Got so much ahead of you. What other things are you kind of like planning on in life, in terms of school, in terms of other things that you do?
I want to go to college and get some degree in exercise science, something along those lines, because it interests me. Regionals next year, I'll be there. So.
Well, congratulations on your big win.
Thank you so much.
Dallin Pepper, we are 2 for 2 on shot calls for 2019. Dallin Pepper, not to go unnoticed, and we really didn't talk about it a ton just because of how dominant he was. He's going to be back in this division next year. This is his first year. He aged up, and a lot of the athletes we've talked to that are 17 said, hey, listen, when I was 16 and I came here last year, there was an adjustment from the lower division.
Not so much Dallin Pepper. Now, is Dallin Pepper going to be able to do next year what Haley Adams has done this year?
He certainly set the table.
If he doesn't make regionals and or qualify for the Games as an individual, who knows what 12 months can bring for this young man.
It's never happened, but certainly as the teenagers continue to excel, training continues to grow, focus for some of these young men and ladies continues to come onto CrossFit, it's bound to happen sooner or later. Dallin Pepper, two times a CrossFit Games champion.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's with my pleasure to announce your winner of the Teenage Boys 16 and 17-year-olds with 824 points. Make some noise, Madison, for your Teenage Boys champion, Dallin Pepper!
Crowning the fittest on earth in the Masters Divisions here at the 2018 Reebok CrossFit Games, men's 35-39, event number 11. Complex Fran here at the Age Group Pavilion. Jeremy Austin, Nikki Brazier down on the floor. Joel Gadeck, glad to have you along with us. How do we twist Fran for this one?
Complex Fran, this is the 11th test for these Masters over the whole week here in Madison. For time, we got 7 bar muscle ups, 7 chest bar, 7 pull up, 21 thrusters. We'll do 5-5-5 and 15, 3-3-3 and 9. The reverse order of the normal Fran. It is the same weight, however, 95 pounds or about 42.5 kilos. 7-minute time cap, but these guys well and truly are going to go sub 4. Bold prediction, I think.
Kyle Casper Bauer is your leader. He is leading by more than 100 points, so barring disaster and he not finishing the event, he pretty much has this thing locked up. But it's an interesting battle for the podium. Joel Levay is in second. He is in lane 11. You saw Kyle Kleinschmidt in lane 9. 142-point lead for Kyle Casper Bauer, trying to become the first back-to-back champion in the Masters Division 35-39.
I'm going to put a wager on right now that he will, and he will win this event.
Underway with Complex Fran. It's also just the second year of the 35-39 Masters grouping.
But if you're going 2-2, that's okay. Way to call your shot. Is he going to do Rashawn Ramirez? That's the biggest one we're going to worry about.
Well, he's got to do muscle ups, chest to bar, and regular pull ups first. Break down this thing for me.
Strategy really, really important with the bar muscle up, chest to bar pull up, and pull up. Kyle choosing to jump down from the bar muscle ups. If you can go unbroken, you are going to get this thing done a lot quicker. Kyle breaking it up into 3 different sets. And if you're wanting this title, if you want to sit on that podium at the end of today, you are going to have to go to that place of hurt. And we know worldwide that when you do, Fran, you hurt pretty bad. This is just a little bit worse.
Cole Marshburn in the blue shirt, with the blue headband. Joel Brand is in the blue shirt immediately in front of you. Starling on the outside looking in at that podium. He would have to do well with Kleinschmidt and Joel Levay tumbling. But they can certainly flip-flop between second and third. 7-minute sprint. Joel Levay back to the bar for the muscle-ups. His favorite workout of all time is open workout 17.3. It's a chest-to-bar snatch ladder. So this event's in his wheelhouse, and you can see his chest knocking off the bar. The chest does have to touch the bar. We saw Casper Bauer catch a no rep on his first set.
Did notice that he did start doing his butterfly chest-to-bar pull-ups where that body sweeps through, but he got caught halfway through the chest to bar pull-ups and had to revert to a normal kipping pull-up. But once he got that first kipping pull-up out of the way, straight back to work with a butterfly and then seamless transition into those pull-ups. But the battle for the podium, Kleinschmidt, can he hang on to that third place that he has at the moment? Can he sneak into second? It's only a 10-point gap for Jolivet. For Kasper Bauer, getting to work in the pink shorts.
Jolivet rolls his bar forward first. So he is in the lead, trying to secure second with Kleinschmidt behind. Jolivet's second time to the CrossFit Games has already picked up his first career event win this year. He was 13th a year ago. Can he jump all the way up to second?
A little bit of a stumble from Jolivet on the riser underneath the pull-up bar. But the race is on now.
Travis Stetzel has also made his way to the thrusters. He was first. Starling is there as well. Jolivet is being pushed by Philip Kniep to his right. Kniep drops the bar. Race to the line. Kniep! Jolivet went head first. The timing chip is on your ankle. It was a Ross Palkin, I stand corrected, who got in 0.04 of a second ahead.
How close was that race to the line? It was all on the timing chip in their feet. If it was head over the line, Jolivet gets it. Oh, what a tight race to the finish. It was like the last 10 seconds. It was like 10 finishes.
Kasper Bauer winds up eighth. It's no bother. He had a big enough cushion. Palkin came in overall in fifth. So 100 points for Ross Palkin, and he winds up having himself quite the games. His second event victory.
Brand getting those chest to bar pull-ups and those pull-ups completed. And if we know how strong he is from shoulder to overhead, so not a whole lot of hip drive happening for Joel Brand. 300 pounds from shoulder to overhead on day two of competition. No thrust is easy for him.
Palkin with the first place finish there. Will podium.
Plants on rest, right? Plants on rest.
Pain for Justin King.
But he's pretty pumped, I think, to be finished. Got some battle scars to take home with him.
Palkin wins the event and will make his way to third. Take a look at how it happened.
The first part of it, a lot of strategy going on. How do you break these bar muscle up, chest to bar pull-ups and pull-ups up? Jolivet got into a great rhythm and rested a lot on those thrusters. But Palkin, just to the right of the screen in the blue shorts, just following Jolivet back for the final round. But Jolivet trying to hold him off, hot on his tail, Palkin. And the race for the thrusters was on. And if you won't see a closer finish than this, and if Jolivet gets that foot first instead of the head first, he gets the win and knocks the barrier out, pushes the people away. But whoa, what an incredible finish. Ross Palkin, under half a second involved, 1v2. It doesn't even look like he's done anything.
So Palkin gets his spot in third, after winning event number 11. Overall leader, though, is Kyle Kasper Bauer. How about flying under the radar? Just his second event win. He wins overall, and he's with Nikki.
we were just saying that we haven't done many of these interviews because there haven't been many other wins, but that really wasn't necessary in order to climb to the top of the podium. You said that was fun. What did you mean by that?
Oh, it was a fun workout. It got a little grippy, but just the intensity. The whole weekend was just a lot of fun, and the division, the gentlemen that I was competing against, the dads, the workers, I love it. So a lot of fun this weekend.
Going into this season of CrossFit Games, how much of it was your goal to become a back-to-back champ?
That was the only goal. It was the reason that I started training after last year, fully just committing myself to the Masters division, to the 35 to 39, not looking back at all. And it paid off. It was a lot of fun again. The people that I competed with, the guys, they're great. Every single one of them, class acts.
We've seen your family on the sidelines. Your kids are here. They made some signs for you. What does that mean for you?
Oh, that means so much. My wife, she kept it a secret. And then when I was walking out yesterday, I saw them, the signs, and my kids holding them up. I'm like, oh my gosh, I can't do this right now. I gotta focus. But no, that's love right there. I love my children. I love my family. I love my fans. So I love the CrossFit community. This is great. So
congratulations.
Thank you.
Kyle, Casper Bauer wins again, and I fully get the emotional bit with your kids when you're trying to focus on an event and then something like that pops up. But what a great 4 days of competition for Kyle Casper Bauer, with only 2 wins, as you mentioned, Joel, but enough to propel him for his second championship in the second year of the 35 to 39 Masters division.
Kyle Casper Bauer, back to back. We'll bump it up an Andrew. Neil Maddox will try to claim his first CrossFit Games crown. That's coming up next.
Right here is going to do it. Anybody with Ramirez? You guys better get on your feet. Put your arms up. Here we go. We might have to try that one again, but that was pretty good. That was pretty good. I think that's all I had. That's about a 30-meter walk. Goodness. No offense, fellas. So since we're all hyped up, it is with absolute pleasure to introduce your 2018 Reebok CrossFit Games 35 to 39 champion, 820 points. I love saying this name, Kyle Casper Bauer.
gentlemen, let's welcome our master stand 40-44. And number one, Matthew Morris. Number two, Dennis Marshall. And number three, Jason Kelly. Number six, Justin LaSalle. And number seven, Mike Evers. And number 13, Joe Corvo. Number 14, Gary Pasca. Number 15, Jeb Simmons. And number 16, Steven Swistak. And number 17, Michael Kern. And number 18, Bradley Pritchard. And number 19, Brad Becker. Place with 434 points, David Johnson. In fourth place with 556 points, Jason Grubb. In third place with 614 points, David Levy.
Neil Maddox has been to the CrossFit Games now 8 times, but has never won a championship. It's event 11 in the men's masters 40-44 Complex Fran here at the Age Group Pavilion, Alliant Energy Center, the 2018 Reebok CrossFit Games. This could very well be Neil Maddox's coronation. Jeremy Austin, Joel Gannett, Nikki Brazier, Complex Fran. It's Fran with a twist.
It sure is, and a nasty twist at that. 7 bar muscle ups, 7 chest bar pull ups, and 7 pull ups, then followed by 21 thrusters. We'll proceed with 5, 5, and 5, and a 15 thruster set, then into the 3s and a 9 thruster set. The difference with this and Fran is they've swapped the movements over to make it a little bit nastier. 95 pounds, 42 and a half kilos on the barbell, and 7 minute time cap.
Neil Maddox, your leader in lane 10. David Levy fighting for a podium in third place right now. He's in lane 9. Lane 11 belongs to the four-time defending champ in this division, the Ram, Sean Ramirez. Neil Maddox was second in the Masters 35-39 a year ago. His best finish in the open division was 9th back in 2013. Speechless yesterday, could not find the words to describe what a championship would mean for him. Head to the bar first, and as best you can, Jeremy, unbroken.
Oh, it's all about a race. We know Fran is a very quick workout. This event is just going to get really nasty, really fast. So if you can get this done unbroken, that is going to be a massive key. A number of athletes choosing to break up the bar muscle up, but then going into the chest to bar and the pull up in one complete set. So 7 reps to start and then a complete 14 before they move on to the thrusters. If you've got to go, you've got to go, but you've got to go to that place of hurt if you want to get onto that podium. And one of those guys on the podium is David Levy at the moment.
David Levy, the South African, a Masters rookie, former Open Division Games competitor in 12 and 13, has shown really well for himself, and man, he is just pumping out the thrusters. Sean Ramirez on the right, the four-time defending champ, was going for the clean sweep in this division, and just ran into Neil Maddox, who does have enough points coming into this event that as long as he completes it, they'll have the championship wrapped up. But the respect between those two men that we saw yesterday, Neil Maddox said, listen, he's a champion. He showed he's a champion. And I have never had more respect than I do right now for Sean Ramirez.
Oh, it was just an incredible battle back and forth. And the support that Sean Ramirez has got here, not just in the event, but also over the last 4 years, there's the army of blue. Plenty of Ramirez shirts around. And he wants to finish on a high. He knows the title has slipped away. But that doesn't mean he's going to put the foot off the pedal. And just, they have sat here the entire week and cheered for Sean Ramirez. He is such a very big family man. but such a great competitor. And Neil touched on that yesterday.
His kids are important to him, too. He says, hey, I'm getting older, I'm dad, but I'm still cool enough that my kids love to come stand on the podium with me here. Neil Maddox cranking out these thrusters. Once a CrossFit Games championship. He's never had one, although he told us yesterday, too, it's not for him.
No, he's
his
got
mind's
other people
in a different
in
place. Yeah. About a week and a half ago, his mother went to the hospital. A shout out to Patricia Maddox back in California. Suffers from emphysema, asthma, from years of smoking. The air quality with all the wildfires in California has been tough for her. She's been in the hospital. Neil actually thought there was a time he was going to have to withdraw, leave, and go back and tend to her. She is his world. Patricia Maddox was a single parent growing up. Neil saying she was mom, she was dad, she was everything. You only get one mom. Didn't grow up with a lot, relied on love with each other. Neil Maddox winning for himself, which is huge, but man, does he want this for Patricia Maddox.
Maddox now onto those last nine thrusters. He has put some distance between him and Ramirez, but the Ram is on the warpath.
Neil just got a no rep, but now back into a groove. Sean Ramirez cranking them out. You can see the barbell moving just off screen, right? And now there is the Ram. Neil Maddox drops the bar and finishes for the first time. Neil Maddox is a CrossFit Games champion. And Sean Ramirez pushed him the whole way. Tim Dibble finishes in third.
Ramirez, he'll be here for a while if he's going to thank all his supporters. Ebert's stumbling over the line, as does Johnson. Oh, no better sight. I think it just got a little bit of dust in here.
He doesn't have to wait.
Someone's cutting up onions.
He doesn't have to wait for the podium to hang out with his kids. Got one cool dad. It's a sprint event, 4.5 minutes on the clock, 7 minute time cap.
Gladiators all week.
Former team competitors years back. And look at Neil Maddox saying hey to the Ramirez supporters.
He has thanked everybody in every position, volunteers, judges, signage staff, scorers, everybody that's been here volunteering. He has gone and thanked not only just them, but also his fellow competitors. True gentleman, Neil Maddox.
2 minutes left of work going on behind Neil Maddox. Joe Corvo.
I've really been impressed with Joe Corvo this week.
Games rookie Joe Corvo is done.
He'll be back.
Most famous guy in the gym.
Yeah, I know, but he'll be back here on the floor next year.
NHL guy hoping to make his mark in CrossFit. Showed very well this year. Neil Maddox showed best. There is still one competitor out on the floor.
Neil Maddox has just done something on the floor. He's just left his shoes out on the floor and wiped his hands as if to say that he is done. I'm sure this story is going to unfold.
Neil did tell us before these games he had no desire to go back to the main open division. He went to regionals this year because it was fun, and he's content being a master. Is he content with a championship?
You did mention this meant the world to him to get a title. He's done that. And those shoes under the bar and him walking off. Is this the last we see of Neil Maddox in competition at the CrossFit Games? He's put us all into a state of shock. Thank
you guys. 7 seconds left for Steve Swistak on the other side of the floor from Maddox. but it's all about Neil. Event 11 in the books. Swistak had many of his competitors cheering him on to the finish there. Neil Maddox for both he and his mom, a CrossFit champion.
He's been such a great competitor over so many years, and if you're going to finish with that sort of event that's in your wheelhouse, thrusters and pull-ups are going to be hit. So to finish this CrossFit Games event with a Fran complex, or a complex Fran, you could call it, awesome. But Neil Maddox has just been so dominant over the entire week.
Neil Maddox's shoes on the floor, and Neil Maddox is with Nikki.
I mean, I think we have an idea of what it means. Yeah. The shoes on the floor. I'm getting a little emotional too. What's going on?
That's it. I've devoted a lot of my life to this sport, and I love this sport, but the next evolution is family. I'm getting married, and I want to dedicate myself to getting athletes where I'm at. My program, Maddox Method, that I'm going to be putting out to get people where I'm here. I only came out here to train to compete against Sean Ramirez. The guy's a true champion. I take my hat off to him. He pushed all weekend, but he called me out, and I answered the call. I mean, that last workout before this, my back is all messed up, but this last one, I got to go out with a punch, and that's what I did. And I'm just blessed to be here and be able to experience the individual 35 to 39, 40 to 41. I finally did it.
And you said that this whole week wasn't even all for you. This was for your mom, yep. Correct? Yeah.
It's for my mom. You know, this gold medal doesn't go to me. It goes to my family. It goes to my future wife. They're the ones who made this happen. If you have the right people around you and the great support group, anything can happen. And for the first time in my life, I actually have it. And a lot of the cars came together, and I feel so blessed and so thankful.
Neil, every time we see you on the floor here, you high-five and shake hands with every volunteer, every person on the staff. You're known for that. Why do you do that?
Because without them, they don't make this. They make this happen. All the years I've been here, you have amazing people who devote their time, take away from their family to make it happen for us. And to be out here in the Masters division and these people devoting their time to us, I have to show respect to them. My hat goes out to them. Hat goes off to them because they're the one who make this happen. They make this possible for us to compete and be here every day. So much respect to all the people who are in the blue, yellow, any shirt that is volunteering, because they make this amazing event that much more amazing.
Neil, congrats on your win and your incredible career.
Thank you very much. I mean, you might see me in the 45, but I'm taking some years off to enjoy life and train athletes and get myself recentered.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It took 8 trips to the CrossFit Games. Neil and Patricia Maddox are CrossFit Games champions. And we may very well have just seen the conclusion of one of the great CrossFit careers in the history of the sport of fitness.
Talk about emotional roller coasters. I know Nikki got a little bit choked up then. What an amazing person, competitor, challenger for the title here. He is just an awesome human being and epitomizes what we want to see in the sport of CrossFit. And the two biggest competitors you're likely to see, we're not just talking stature either, we're talking personalities.
We knew it was going to be a dogfight between those two, Jeremy.
I didn't expect Neil to just say, righto, I've beaten Sean, I'm out of here. That's went in a state of shock. Because I normally know what putting shoes on the floor means, but wow.
We got everything we expected. And the send-off for Neil Maddox.
Someone's still cutting onions here.
The handoff from Ramirez to a great champ.
16, Chris Abbott. 9, 17, Les Schneider. Lane number 18, Eddie Simpson. And lane number 8, in fifth place, going into today, Brett Meyer. Lane 4, lane 12, rather, in fourth place, Archer Omorowski. And lane number 9, in third place, Nathan Lauren.
Back inside the Age Group Pavilion, Alliant Energy Center, Madison, Wisconsin. Men's 45-49, event number 11. It's Complex Fran, and it is the finale here at the 2018 Reebok CrossFit Games for these gentlemen. Jeremy Austin, Joel Gaudet, Nikki Brazier. Complex Fran is Fran with a twist.
Event number 11, and what a way to go out with a bang. We've seen Fran before, but this is a little bit of a twist. 7 bar muscle ups, 7 chest to bar, 7 pull ups, 21 thrusters. Then they'll do 5 of each with 15 thrusters. Then 3 of each, 9 thrusters. The weight is 95 pounds, 42 and a half kilos, 7 minute time cap. But we've reversed the order from the normal with the workout. Fran, spit it out.
Robert Davis, the defending champion, is in lane 10. Matthew Swift. He's the defending champion for, like, the last time he was here.
2015, yes. Yeah, they had, like, a bit of a breakout. Yeah.
Davis and Swift have each won a crown the last time they competed this division. They are next to each other. The Italians have shown well, too. Silvino and Luzzi. But it's Davis and Swift.
It's like they're almost clones of each other. They're the same size, shape, and they've got almost identical capacities. And I know Matt Swift loves both thrusters and pull-ups, so look for him to go pretty quick.
There has not yet been a back-to-back champion in the men's 45-49 bracket. Could it be Robbie Davis? Could Matt Swift restake his claim that he left in 2015?
It's going to be one of them, we know that for sure. Keys to this event, Robbie just having a bit of a spill onto that riser that was just there, but getting this done unbroken is going to be ideal. Matt Swift on the right, looking very comfortable at the moment. So 7 bar muscle ups, 7 chest to bars, and then 7 pull ups. Swift getting it all done in under 35 seconds. So that's going to be quick. Once we get into the back end, we know Fran hurts. This is going to hurt even more after 4 days of competition.
Matt Swift, strength, Olympic lifting. Robbie Davis, longer workouts and chippers.
This is not going to be long, unfortunately.
No. Davis with 7:14, Swift in second. Nathan Lauren has come on strong over the last couple of days. A couple of event wins back-to-back. Hand in the air to signify Swift coming down the home stretch of his first set of thrusters. Advance the bar after 21 of them, and then head back to the rig. So Matt Swift, sitting in second place, is the first man to start his second set of muscle-up, chest-to-bar pull-ups.
We wanted a battle right to the end. We've had a battle for the last 3.5 days. These guys are going to be battling it out for the next 2.5 minutes.
Now, the difference is 28 points. So if Swift wins, but Davis is second,
Davis will take it out.
Yep.
And it doesn't look like there is anyone else within cooee of getting in between the two of them.
Matt Swift needs to pop off the bar and start yelling to somebody to speed it up.
Help me out here, friends. Come
hey,
on.
Julio in lane 13. Let's go. Matt Swift doing his job here in the finale, event 11, Complex Fran. He was the champ in 2015, took a couple of years off, doesn't compete all that much, actually. He thinks, listen, I'm a CrossFit athlete, but I have other interests too. I'm a complete human being, and I want to explore all of those things. And granted, CrossFit is about 90% of all of that.
And when you run two CrossFit affiliates with his wife, Wendy, who's come over with the trip, with him. I'm sure you've got your hands full.
Develop the Masters.
Develop the, seminar. The CrossFit Masters seminar. CrossFit Level 2, Level 1. CrossFit Olympic lifting seminars as well. So he's got plenty on his plate.
Robbie Davis has been in the top five three times in the last 4 years, including the champ a year ago. He talked to us about his motivation. First couple of months after winning last year, he said it was hard to get motivated again. I had accomplished the goal. He's found those juices. Second place after day one. Second after day two. Finally took first place after day three. He is in first on the final event. Matt Swift is in first in the event, but Davis atop the leaderboard.
And the only one that could possibly catch Robbie Davis at this point in time is Brent Meyer, but he has got some work to do.
Meyer really swinging on those muscle ups. The fatigue sets in.
That's a big frame to get above the bar as well. Swift killing it.
Matt Swift is done, and he's finished. He's done his work. Now, can Robbie Davis come in second? Because if he does, he's gone back-to-back. Hand in the air, inside five reps, Robbie Davis. Champ in 2017, Robbie Davis in 2018.
What a great battle we've seen over the last 4 days of competition. Lead going back and forth. Robbie only getting one event win. Matt only getting one event win. Brent Meyer finishing up. What a great way to finish for him.
Nathan Lauren has podiumed on a team before, and he came into this in third place. Komorowski was in fourth, finishes behind him.
Geez, not much separated those two, Swift and Davis.
Robbie Davis will be 48 next year as well. He'll have a chance to come back and try for the three-peat.
Let's go again. If his motivation was down for this year, what do you do with two of those titles?
Well, three sounds nice.
Well, three. Let's just round it up to three.
It'll be Davis, Swift, and Lauren here in the 45-49 age division. Wes Schneider in the blue trying to finish strong. The same going for Clint Paddock on his last nine thrusters. And Bruce Thomas, Mighty Mouse, in lane three.
Bruce Thomas.
Over the bar and down your lane, and inside the 7 minute cap for Bruce Thomas. There's Jason Miller. It's a good showing for Jason Miller. He's been all over the place in finishes, but as a games rookie has come in, he's gotten two event wins and gives himself a nice foundation going forward. Last rep for Eddie Simpson. And inside 15 seconds to close out the 2018 Reebok CrossFit Games for these men.
10 seconds remaining. We're going to count down.
Schneider is done with his 15s. And that'll do it. Matt Swift pushed the envelope, but he could not catch.
Very, very proud Aussie and former winner. And a great finish, 4:01 with Complex Fran. That's nice and quick. It's a great combination of gymnastics movements on that bar, and they went neck and neck. Swift getting an early lead. Robbie having a bit of a stumble on his way through the first set. Once Swift got out in front, those almost picture-perfect thrusters that you see from Matt Swift propelling him forward. And the last couple of pull-ups and thrusters, hurting a touch. But what a great finish from Matt Swift.
Swift puts himself on the podium. He'll be standing right next to his longtime friend, Robbie Davis. They go 1-2 overall. They go 1-2 in this event. Chris Exaros shows well, finishing third. Former Wisconsin Badger. But Robbie Davis is the man of the hour with Nikki.
It's been a complete battle for almost every event here between you and Matt Swift, and I know that that helps push you to the end. How did you sort of use that to propel you toward the top of the podium?
It was awesome. I mean, coming here this year, I knew Matt was going to be my main guy, another pre-champion, always a solid lifter, just well-rounded guy, a gentleman on top of it, you know. So knowing that, I trained a lot, trying to make sure I covered all the holes in my gap.
How much of a goal was back-to-back championships?
It was a tough year, I'm not going to lie. You know, it took a lot to stay focused this year. You know, they say it takes a village. It took a village to keep me on point and you know, still wanting it is bad. But once you get here, it's just kind of fall into place. Competition brings the best out of you, so.
I know a lot of guys in the division talk about how difficult it is sometimes balancing CrossFit and everything else you've got going on in this stage of life. How difficult was it for you?
Yeah, I mean, I started a new job this year, so less time. I'm not just a owner entrepreneur, so I have a schedule, times to get in, coaching with the gym still. So it was really difficult. I mean, it gave me a whole new perspective of all the guys that have been doing it all this time.
Congratulations on a fantastic week here.
Cheers. Thanks very much. Thanks, guys.
Robbie Davis, first back-to-back crowns in the 45-49 men's masters division. Champion in 2017, champion in 2018.
And a true gentleman as well. He said that about Matt Swift, but Robbie Davis epitomizes what we like to see. He's such a humble guy as well. And what a awesome weekend it's been for the 45-49 division. Didn't have a clear leader until this final couple of minutes of the 11th event. And time to put the shirt on now and get the class photo of 2018.
Thank you.
Out of CrossFit Bonedale, Robbie Davis.
Complex Fran is the task at hand. The final event for the Masters women ages 35 to 39 here at the Age Group Pavilion, Alliant Energy Center, Madison, Wisconsin, the 2018 Reebok CrossFit Games. He's our kilogram converter, Jeremy Austin. Joel Gadeck, glad to have you along with us. Nikki Brazier's down on the floor. Tell us about Complex Fran.
Complex Fran. So we're just going to do Fran, but we're going to make it a little bit harder. But we're going to swap the movements around as well. So 7 bar muscle ups, 7 chest bars, 7 pull ups on that rig you see on screen. 21 thrusters. Then they'll move back and do 5-5-5 and 15 thrusters. The 3s and 9 thrusters. The weight for these ladies is super light at 65 pounds. We're talking 29.1 kilos. 7 minutes on the time clock.
Decimals, folks. He's got the decimals in there.
We have to convert down there during the open. It's fun.
Lana Simons, Anna Tobias, your leader in lane 10. Helena Falk, Sam Briggs looking at the podium. 18 competitors. Chasing Tobias. Oh,
what can you not say about Anna Tobias and what she has done the entire week we've been here? 4 days of competition. 3 individual wins. And she's had 3 second places as well. 3rd place a couple of events ago. But just so consistent over the entire week. Doesn't matter what Mr. Castro has thrown at these athletes. Anna's met the challenge.
Start with the bar muscle ups. Jeremy, you want to see these ladies go as unbroken as possible.
Oh, it's just going to cut down that time between you and that finish mat, which is where you are going to get majority of points. Number of athletes choosing to come off the bar after the bar muscle ups and then do the 14 reps unbroken. Samantha Briggs are not choosing that path, or Anna Tobias, surprisingly.
They come off simultaneously. Tobias gets under her barbell first. And Tobias is cycling these 65 pounds. Sam Briggs had a tough start. 15th, 13th, and 7th in her first 3 events. She was 13th after day 1. Then she was 7th. Then she was 3rd. She's now in 2nd place. She was looking to be the first Open Division winner, 2013 Games champion, to grab a Masters crown too. But Anna Tobias gave her a formidable fall, the Olympic gold medalist.
It's funny, we go back to day 2 of competition. Sam Briggs is in 13th still after an event win. And we're going, how do you win an event and stay in 13th?
He almost looked at it and said, how is she ever going to move? And then she continued to grab ones. Here is Tobias, who's been around a long time. This her 6th games. Her best finish was 9th in the year that Briggs won, 2013. The Olympic sailing champion just got a no rep, her chest missing the bar. You have to make contact. Briggs takes advantage of the no rep. Tobias just now getting to the straight pull-ups as opposed to the chest to bar, and Briggs is in front.
So Samantha Briggs has had a fairly good run over the last couple of days. Her last 6 events, first, 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 second, first, first.
What happened in the swim?
Second.
Yeah, I mean, what?
Well, Anna Tobias got first.
Well, she's a sailor.
The sailor who also swims. Beat it to the punch. But a very normal, unnormal slow start for Samantha Briggs with a three consecutive 15th. But then after that, I'll tell you what, the foot has been down and no stone unturned for Samantha Briggs.
Tobias rolling the bar forward onto her last set. Briggs on your left, Tobias on your right. Helena Falk looking at a podium spot in third in the white, now on the right side of your screen. 3 minutes and change into this 7 minute time cap event. Sam Briggs onto her final set of nine thrusters. Front squat into a push press.
Sam was probably hoping this was going to be like a triple Fran complex. Something harder. Because she has crushed absolutely everything in the last 2.5 days.
Tobias catching up to her. Briggs over the bar. Sam Briggs, another event W. Dynamite. Days 2, 3, and 4. Kelly Holm pulls out second place. Tobias drops the bar. That's third. And Myra Brandt is into the clubhouse as well. Tobias began with a more than 100-point lead. She will be your champion in this division. We're figuring out the rest of the podium. Sam Briggs right behind her. But third becomes interesting. Falk is still on the floor. Holm was in fourth, and she's already finished. And now Navarro comes in and scoring points here with everyone that goes by. Helena Falk finishes. That is a sixth place finish, and with it comes 56 points. Kirsten Pedry. That's seventh. Trojanowski on the left. Delamere on the right. Jenna Larson and Sarah Scholl. The spirit rapper, then Sarah Scholl. Jimena Delamere, the Argentinian. Unofficially, we do have Tobias Briggs Falk as our top three.
Not only do we have that, we have a lot of leg fatigue. So the thrust is the last thing these athletes want to be seeing at the back end of a four-day competition.
Delamere is done.
Oh, what a great job in finishing up.
There's just something poetic about ending the CrossFit Games on a thruster.
There's a combo you don't want to see at the end of a competition, or any time, really. But at the end of 4 days of competition, just nasty.
Trojanowski trying to get in under the cap. On her last set of nine, she will do so. Hand in the air as she comes down the stretch from her judge. Chastity Snowden. Jenna Larson, a finisher. And the time cap proving to be no match for many of these women. That's Delana Snyder in lane two. And that'll wrap the field.
Samantha Briggs. What a wonderful competitor Samantha Briggs has been over many years. First time we've seen her here in the 35-39 division. She did mention she wants to go back, play with the individuals next year. But this is Samantha Briggs' jam. Those awesome bar muscles, getting those hips up nice and high. But Tobias just trailing her early. But it was a no point because Sam Briggs put the foot down and no one was going to catch Samantha Briggs. Her sixth event win, 600 points with Samantha Briggs.
The event win to Briggs. Kelly Holm comes in second. Anna Tobias third, but it is the CrossFit Games Championship here in 2018 that goes to Anna Tobias, and she is with Nick.
Such a consistent week to skyrocket you to the top of the leaderboard. Tell me about your training going into this game season in this Masters division in comparison to what we saw from you as an individual.
So we started the season planning on going team. We got team to regionals, and so my training changed a little bit, so we're focusing on kind of team training. And I think in a way, the faster, shorter sprint style kind of complemented what I would say would be more my strengths in individuals. So putting those together after regionals and training for this kind of really helped develop it.
Nice. Now, we have seen you in a team. We've seen you as an individual. Your first time out on the Masters 4. How did this experience compare?
Everyone is its own, you know, individual thing. But it was awesome. The girls were great, super friendly. The crowd in here was great, cheering everyone on. It was a great time.
I know you are yet again an Olympic hopeful for 2020. So now you'll be sort of balancing your CrossFit training with your sailing training. How do you plan on doing that?
Yeah, so the focus is definitely switching to the 2020 Olympics. Definitely going to keep training CrossFit, keep competing when I can and as much as I can. I love it, and just got to kind of balance all of it together now.
Will we see you out here again?
Hopefully.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Anna Tobias locks up a CrossFit championship. She leads the way for the women 35-39 at the 2018 Reebok CrossFit Games.
What a great battle we've had over the last 4 days. Like, Tobias was just so consistent. Only 3 event wins, but 4 second place finishes. But winning isn't only the thing you have to focus on. Consistency, more so the key. And Samantha Briggs having a bit of trouble getting in the country. And once she got here and got settled, 6 event wins, 600 points, but it wasn't enough to hold out our champ, Anna Tobias. Awesome performance.
CrossFit gold and Olympic gold. 2 spots on the mantle for Tobias.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's with my pleasure to crown our champion here in the Masters Women's Division, 35-39. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a big round of applause with a score of 902 points. Our champion, Anna Tobias!
Melissa Wistrom. Over in Jen Dieter. Over in lane number 14, Allie Crawford. In lane 15, Anna Caldish. In lane 16, Laura Nielsen. In lane number 17, Aaron Carter. Lane number 16, Janet Black. In lane number 19, Sarah Franklin. Lane number 20, Hannah Kaminsky. Back in lane number 13, fifth place going into this event, Karen McAdam. Lane number 12, sitting fourth place, Jessica Martinez.
Just 6 points separate the top two on the leaderboard in the Women's Masters 40-44 leaders event number 11, Complex Fran. It's the finale of the Reebok CrossFit Games 2018 here at the Age Group Pavilion, Alliant Energy Center in Madison, Wisconsin, with Jeremy Austin, Joel Gaudette, Nikki Brazier on the floor, along with some barbells, because we've got Complex Fran.
Yeah, we've got a pull-up rig as well. Bit of a swap out with our normal Fran of pulling movements going first. So we've got 7 bar muscle ups, 7 chest bar, 7 pull ups, 21 thrusters. And it is going to be at 65 pounds, so nice and light for these ladies. 5, 5, 5, and 15 thrusters, 3, 3, 3, and 9 thrusters. And about, I reckon, about 4.5 minutes or so. Well under that 7 minute time cap.
Stephanie Roy is your leader for most of the week. She comes in second place. She is in lane 10, chasing down Kelly Friel. She is in lane 11.
What a great battle we've seen over the last couple of days. Two in particular. Kelly Friel, rookie appearance here at the Masters Division. Two event wins. Can she make it three and make it a rookie title? Oh, I'm sure Stephanie's got something to say about that.
Friele, Games rookie, was the fifth seed coming in out of the qualifier. Talked about it this morning. Her goal was just to be fifth. She's got a chance not only to be on the podium, but to be on the top of the podium as long as she defends her turf. Roy now on to the chest to bar.
Thinking back over the last couple of days with Kelly Friel to the left of screen, the high skill gymnastics movements are not her favorite movements. We saw that with the muscle up, we saw that with the handstand push up, but all that other extra stuff she loves doing. This is where Stephanie could really get ahead and stay ahead.
Stephanie Roy on the right. Some 5-6 reps ahead of Friel as she starts her thrusters. Roy won the first ever championship in the 35-39 Masters division a year ago. She did it without an event win. She almost put herself in position to do the same thing again this year, but she did win the chipper yesterday. And if she's going to win back-to-back titles, she likely has to win this event here.
The first portion complete, but she isn't the first heading back. It is going to be McAdam to start the second complex. So this will be 5 bar muscle ups. It will be 5 chest to bars, and McAdam are making very easy work. There's not even a transition at the top of that bar muscle up, so it's no wonder she's out in front. 5 bar muscle up, 5 chest to bar, and then 5 pull up. And looking really easy for Karen McAdam.
Could she be a foil here, second to Helen Harding in this age division a year ago, lost by 24 points? Depending on where she finishes in the standings and takes some valuable points away, that mixes things up between both Friel and Roy. First place, fourth, 100. Second, 90. Third, 80. And then it becomes an 8-point differential through sixth place.
I really like the way McAdams on the right of screen is popping those hips open before the press happens. You don't want to be starting to press early. So the hip opening first and then the press off the shoulders.
Friel, by the way, is still back at the pull-up ring. There are 9 women ahead of Friel. She cannot afford a 10th place finish here. Not with Stephanie Roy burning. 3 minutes in. On to her final round here, Roy. Friel is in all kinds of trouble.
Now that fatigue starting to kick in for Stephanie. On those, I think she's got 1 bar muscle up remaining. But the thing is, all she has to do is stay ahead of Kelly Friel.
Now transitions to Chestabar. 3 of those into a regular pull-up. She failed on the last. So 1 more Chestabar. And now 3 pull-ups.
You say it like it's going to be easy, but their grip strength is absolutely smoked.
McAdam wins. She entered in 5th place. Stephanie Roy. She came in 6 points back. Hand in the air. Stephanie Roy. Kimden drops her ball. Roy tripped. Kimden gets in 2nd. Roy is 3rd. 80 points for Stephanie Roy. Will that be enough?
And now Jen Peter will run across 4:30. Janet Black will cross the
finish. Oh, Kelly Friel. She's still battling on, trying to finish. She has completed the chest bars. The arms are crazy tired. And now she's only got those thrusters to go.
Shannon O'Dell and Marina Novelli.
And those are legs must be absolutely on fire for all of these ladies on the floor. It has been a massive challenge.
O'Dell just finishes. Jeremy, there's not enough points. Friel finishes. There are not enough points left on the floor. Stephanie Roy with the 12th place finish by the leader. Stephanie Roy looks like she may have just locked up back-to-back titles as Anna Caldish battling shoulder issues, struggling on the bar.
Pretty emotional day today. No different for this division. 40 to 44. They ride a wave of emotion the entire week. I think the realization now that she may have grabbed that title, and maybe all the cameras in her face as well. But the tears are flowing here in the H Pavilion.
Stephanie Roy, being just 40 years of age, aging into this bracket, said before the game started she doesn't know much about many of the women she was competing against, and said that's perfect because she didn't want to spectate. She wanted to run her race and control herself, and that's what it came down to on the final day. She did her job, and because of it, she's going to win the CrossFit Games 2 years in a row.
That's probably a good thing coming into competition, not having any preconceived ideas of where you should finish in relation to your competitors. Focus on your own game, and the results will come. And just like the 45-49 for the men battle that went on back and forth, this battle went back and forth. Joey Kimden pretty proud of her efforts as well. McAdam getting the win.
It's in the event first, number 11.
That's the first event win for Karen McAdam here at the 2018 Games, trying to play foil.
That's it. McAdam getting out, taking that lead with those really fast, efficient bar muscle ups, like almost flawless with that hip getting up close to the bar and just that quick turnover. That allowed her to get into the pull-ups, get through them really quick, and just get out to that lead and stay comfortable. If you can stay comfortable in something that's called Fran. But a great result for Karen McAdam. Finish for Roy. Joey Kimden to the left. And those legs just have refused to work for Stefan here. She comes over. And it's not going to trigger that time until that timing chip on the left ankle comes over the red finish mat. But it doesn't matter. She's had a great 4 days of competition.
Stephanie Roy, the lone Canadian in the top 10, winds up third in the event, which is good enough to put her at the top of the leaderboard. Stephanie Roy is a two-time CrossFit Games champion.
Even with that trip over the bar at the very end, you still got the points that you needed to get to the top of the leaderboard, and you're a little bit emotional right now. What's going through your mind?
It's all the work this last year and all the preparation, the hard work, and it was tough this week. Always got 1-2, 1-2, bad finish. It's a release now.
Now, it's definitely a huge competition. You said you've been flip-flopping at the top of the leaderboard. There also seems to be a lot of camaraderie down here on the floor between you ladies. What? You all are friends,
yeah,
is that correct?
It's always like this. I am always missing this picture. girls are friendly, and it's a good thing.
We'll get you in that picture 1 second. One last question for you moving forward. Do you take a break? Do you go straight back into training? What is your plan?
Of course, I'm going to take a break, but I'm not going to stop. I'm going to do what my coach told me. If it's 2 weeks, it's 2 weeks. If it's 1 month, it's 1 month.
Well, hopefully we see you again. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Stephanie Roy, CrossFit Games champion. First time in the 40 to 44 age bracket. She picks up right where she left off a year ago.
That's a good reason why you do miss the photo at the end of the competition, because you are doing the winner's interview. But jumping up that division proved to be no challenge. Stephanie Roy.
She takes the crown and she takes the glory. It's Stephanie Roy's floor.
moving and shaking in this last event, your 2018 Reebok CrossFit Games 40-44 division female with 778 points, Stephanie Roy.
Amanda Allen called her shot at the start of the Reebok 2018 CrossFit Games. Can she finish out what she started? The finale of the Masters Age Group Women 45-49 with Jeremy Austin, Nikki Brazier down on the floor. Joel Godet, so glad you chose to spend part of your Sunday here with us. It is event number 11. It's an oldie but a goodie in the sport of fitness, but it's got a twist.
Oh, one of the scariest workouts you'll ever hear of is that word, Fran. And you did mention a little bit of a twist on it. We're going to do a bit of a complex on the pull-up bar. 7 bar muscle ups, 7 chest bars, and 7 pull-ups, followed by 21 thrusters. And it will be at that very light 65 pounds. We're talking about 29.1 kilos. They'll do 5 of each, then they'll get into the 15 thrusters, the 3s, and to the 9 thrusters, 7 minutes on the time cap. But with normal Fran, we've switched which way they do it.
Amanda Allen is your overall leader with 792 points in lane 10. Jolaine Undershoot chasing her down just next to her in lane 11. And then Tanya Osborne is in third in lane 9. Those three will be right in the middle of the floor. Shannon Schleifer in lane 12. The last woman into this division has shown very well. And Nicole Abbott in lane 13 was the number one seed at the start of competition. But Amanda Allen is the number one seed right now.
And one day after the birthday that she did forget yesterday, a great event, the swim. She's a triathlete, and she was hoping the swim would be a whole lot further, but she was so dominant in that, and she's been really dominant right across today. But she did say on Tuesday that she was going to destroy the competition.
There was another word in there too, but
there was. We can't really repeat
that on
air.
For those at home, yeah. We'll leave that out. The top three is locked in. There are only 100 points up for grabs, so we know it will be Allen, Undershoot, and Osborne, but we do not know the order. There is a lot of movement that can happen between those three names at the top.
Now, generically, we go through movements like this. Amanda Allen, not one of her favorite movements, the bar muscle-up. You get someone like Tanya Osborne, who absolutely loves this stuff. undershoot as well in second place, getting through into those chest bar pull-ups nice and early. But if you can get this complex done unbroken, you are going to get off to a great start. And if you want one of those top three podium spots, whichever order it is, you've got to go on one of Hurt to get this done. Tonya Osborne is ready to go into the Hurt Locker, and she is the first to move. And those thrusters really quick.
Osborne making her fifth games appearance. This is her hometown of sorts, from Racine, Wisconsin. Hometown crowd.
Undershoot to the left. How fast is she getting those done? Shorter levers means shorter range of movement, which means faster movement. But undershoot with those powerful legs. Wow.
Which means what kind of disadvantage could Amanda Allen be at as one of the taller athletes right now, and her thrusters are going at a slower pace than undershoot, who moves that bar forward.
Now, it's going to be a lot slower, but I'm sure Amanda has sat back and gone, right, how many points do I need? What placing do I need to get to minimize the damage? This isn't my favorite event. The other two girls are probably going to go out and win and go 1-2. If I finish top five, that's okay. So long as she stays in touch with that top five, I think Amanda Allen is going to be sweet.
Now, we showed you the standings already, but the quick math for you. The difference between first and second is 55 points. The difference between first and third is 70. Sorry, 58 points, first to second. 70, first to third. And, of course, 12 points between third and second. So what medal will go to what woman? How bad do you want it at the 2018 Reebok CrossFit Games?
Going by what's happened in the last age divisions, I reckon there's only about between 60 and 90 seconds left of this event to see who is going to get over the line first. And Tonya Osborne plowing forward now. She's finished third twice. She doesn't want to do that a third time.
Last 2 years for Osborne. Last year, Amanda Allen wasn't here. She missed out on the games, was 26th out of the online qualifier. We've detailed her story endlessly this week, what she's come back from, surgery. You see the scar right down the middle of her abdomen, but her story goes so much deeper. Overcoming suicidal depression, alcoholism. You see the tattoo on her left, or on her right arm, to your left, the unicorn. She said, I am a unicorn. My life is a miracle.
But now she is in a whole lot of bother. That's five failed bar muscle ups. And if she doesn't get a move on, she is under threat of losing that top spot and that title.
She's been your leader after each of the first 3 days of competition. There she gets a rep. Hand in the air for Osborne. Tonya Osborne is your event winner. 822 points for Osborne here in 2018. What place will that put her? Allen has gotten through the bar muscle-ups, now on to the chest-to-bar.
She should be done with that now. It should be just pull-ups now, but oh my lord. That is why Amanda Allen is struggling. Massive rips in those hands, and that is going to make gripping that bar not impossible, it's just uncomfortable.
Shannon Schleifer finishing, and points are vanishing off of the board. Let's talk about the hand for a second. Some people will opt to use grips. Allen does not use those grips. It's just hand, skin on bar, and sometimes that can be the result.
It can be. Sometimes it's good to train without grips just to toughen those hands up a little bit. But with a competition such as this, you're going to get a lot of fatigue, so grips really important to be used. But now the issue is that Amanda Allen and Jolene Undershoot are both failing their bar muscle-ups. And a number of ladies could step in. And as you mentioned, there's a lot of points disappearing. They're disappearing by the second.
And what happens is you start to get the first few finishers in an event. But once you get down to 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, the finishes start coming rapid fire and the points drain off the board quickly. Fourth place will net you 72 points, but 11th will net you 28. And sometimes the difference there is seconds. Jolaine Undershoot, though, gets her job done. She is in second place. Amanda Allen still stuck on the bar.
What I would really like to see her do is get that torso over a little more. You'll see she's got that chicken wing movement happening. So one arm will come over the bar a little bit quicker than the other. That is going to cause more fatigue, and it's going to cause more rips in those hands because there's more friction.
Undershoot has unofficially finished above Osborne with the second place mark. That's 90 points, so 824 for Undershoot to Osborne's 822. But where will Allen fall in the equation? There are already six finishers. Abbott just finished, and we're getting close to the time cap. Now 21 seconds away, Julie Ackerman has finished. She is in seventh. The most points available on the board right now are 44. And Merrill Mullis was there with Allen. Allen got in after her. She's in 10th.
Oh, shakeup of leaderboard coming massively. Oh, wow. Oh, Amanda Allen bleeding profusely from those open wounds on her hands.
Unofficially, my quick math.
Things are tight.
Allen came in with 792 points. She finished 10th, that's 32. She has 824. Undershoot has 824. Osborne wins the event. She has 822.
This is going to be tight. I love a tight race. Amanda Allen, what a great week. She did come in saying she was one of the hardest humans in the world to kill. And she is proving that, even though she is bleeding out of her hands. She's been through so many different things coming through her life, and this is just one of them to make it back.
It will be Amanda Allen unofficially, because Schleifer got in there too. So 8:24 for Amanda Allen, only 8:14 for Undershoot.
Oh, just ridiculously
close. With the
third
place finish.
So close.
We had our eyes so trained on that top three. Schleifer, remember, got in ahead, and Amanda Allen with the 10th place finish on Complex Fran hangs on.
It ain't over till it's over. We have seen some super tight races, but wow, this has been incredible.
Amanda Allen is with Nikki Brazier.
We are still waiting on final results, but it is looking like it could be a possibility. What's going on with your hands? Show us your hands.
So that has never happened before, and it happened on the fifth bar muscle up, and I think I'm covered in my own blood.
It happens. It happens when the competition gets tough. Going into this event, you knew you needed to pull off something good because the competition, man, it was really close. What was your mindset coming to this final event?
We had one plan only, and it was just like little reps, little sets of reps, 3-2-2, absolutely nothing glorious. You like break the thrusters in half, like nothing glorious, like nothing anybody wants to plan. And a whole field was ahead of me, and I just couldn't afford to blow up. You know, I couldn't afford to fail. I did fail quite a few bar muscle ups, I think, because of the blood. But I just found a way to re-grip differently, and it seems that maybe that's going to be enough this year. And fuck,
when we spoke on Friday, you said it's a true miracle that you're here with everything you've dealt with your illnesses and your life leading up to this moment. What would standing on top of that podium mean for you?
Do you know, this morning I was in tears, and after the last workout with the GHD sit-ups, I broke down afterwards, and I feel like, imagine what, you know, people are like on their deathbed when their lives, like, just flash before their eyes. I've had that all day today for the last year, and it's been really emotional, and, like, if I really do stand on top of that podium, I don't know, there's so many people who have been part of making this possible for me and carrying me and loving me and supporting me, and I've finally found my place in the world. Yeah.
Congratulations. Looking forward to seeing what those final numbers look like.
Thank you so much. Yeah, thank you. Yeah.
Amanda Allen. Can't say how proud as a country person of Amanda Allen, the stuff she has gone through in the last 5 to 10 years is just incredible. She is hard to kill, and what a comeback from that surgery to be where she is right now. And I've got to say it, Aussie, 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 oi, oi, oi. Just super proud of her flying the flag in the Masters division. Pretty impressive performance right across the board from Amanda Allen. But also, Undershoot and Osborne. Geez, it got tight towards the end.
That's all you can ask for, man.
Oh, that's right.
All you can ask for.
Blood, sweat, and tears for Amanda Allen. She's thrown them all out in the last day of competition.
Literally, by the way.
I think there's probably less sweat. There was more tears and blood, but we've seen it all here. And what a great battle with these two.
Amanda
Allen.
Please
don't hug me and put your blood all over me.
Yeah. Just be careful with your head. Amanda Allen.
Who would have thought? She actually did say to us, on Tuesday, I am going to destroy the competition. Or was it demolish?
Both.
Destroy.
Both words.
I wouldn't say destroy the competition, but she beat them.
Just enough at the end of the day. Unofficially, Amanda Allen stands tall with her third Masters crown. As always, full final official results online at games.crossfit.com. But judging by the reaction of her competitors, Amanda Allen seems to be their champion. It's been one heck of a week here in Madison, Wisconsin. From history of Haley Adams to Matt Swift making a comeback. You work all year for this. Through trials, tribulations, ups, downs, and injuries. The literal blood, sweat, and tears. The 2018 Reebok CrossFit Games. For Jeremy Austin, for Nikki Brazier, for the rest of our CrossFit crew, my name is Joel Gaudette. It's been an honor and a pleasure to have you with us this weekend. Stay tuned to games.crossfit.com. There is so much more yet to come from the fittest on earth.
Congratulations. That's awesome.
Thank you.
floor, so let's go ahead. It's been a long week. Let's give some medals away. We're going to be starting with our females, 14 and 15-year-old girls, in third place with five top five finishes out of Barbarian CrossFit. Paige Power!
Finisher with four top five finishes, second appearance here at the CrossFit Games, CrossFit Villeray's own Leah Malo. And in her rookie appearance, seven top five finishes out of ESF CrossFit, Olivia Sulik. That is her top three females in our 14 and 15-year-old division. Nice big round of applause. And now on to our 16 and 17-year-old girls. In third place with seven top five finishes, second appearance here at the CrossFit Games, at a CrossFit Unlimited Crawley, Chloe Smith. In second place, third appearance here at the CrossFit Games with eight top five finishes. Let's get hype for CrossFit Hype Zone, Kayla Stefano. All right, and on top of the podium, third appearance here at the CrossFit Game, all events, either first or second out of College Hill CrossFit. Give it up for Haley Adams. Nice big round of applause. That's your 16 and 17-year-old ladies sitting on top of the podium here for the CrossFit Games. All right, next up for the fellas, our younger division, 14 and 15-year-old boys, third place, five top five finishes, second appearance here at the CrossFit Game, Bucksmont CrossFit's own Nolan Petrick. Our second place with eight top five finishes and second appearance here at the CrossFit Games out of CrossFit 845, Christian Gallagher. And heading up on top of that platform, second appearance here at the CrossFit Games with seven top five finishes. Out of Cascade CrossFit, Tudor Magna. And that's your one, two, and three for our 14 and 15-year-old division. Coming up in third place for our 16 and 17-year-old men's division,
third appearance here at the CrossFit Games. Five top five finishes out of CrossFit Maven. Make some noise for Dylan Cade. In second place with five top five finishes and the fourth appearance here for him at the CrossFit Games. Make some noise for Vincent Ramirez. Nine top five finishes. Second appearance here at the CrossFit Games out of Spanish Ford CrossFit. Dolan Pepper. That is your one, two, and three, your fittest teenagers in the world. Next up, our female division, 60 plus division, in third place. Five top five finishes, second appearance here at the CrossFit Games. Out of CrossFit Bluegrass, give it up for Dolores Jones. In second place, six top five finishes, fifth appearance here at the CrossFit Games. Out of CrossFit Fit Farm, give it up for Patty Fela. And in first place, with eight top five finishes and her fourth appearance at the CrossFit Games, out of CrossFit Gold Rush, Sean Havard. That is your 1, 2, 3 in our 60 plus women's division. Next up, our 55 to 59 women's division. In that third place spot, seven top five finishes, and the fifth appearance here at the CrossFit Games, out of CrossFit Black Box, make some noise for Colleen Fahey. Your second place finisher, with her second appearance here at the CrossFit Games, four top five finishes this week. From Solution One CrossFit, Bianca Williams. She's already happy. First place in your women's 55 to 59 division. This is awesome. Seven appearances here at the CrossFit Games. Six top five finishes out of CrossFit Vex. Mary Beth Prodromitis. That is what it's about. Next division up. Your 50 to 54 women in third place, with her fifth appearance here at the CrossFit Games and seven top five finishes, Custer CrossFit's own Linda Elston. And in that number two spot, up on top of the podium,
Her sixth appearance here at the CrossFit Games with seven top five finishes. Lori Mchizanik. And in first place for this division, third appearance here at the CrossFit Games with seven top five finishes, out of CrossFit Algoa, Eva Thornton. Another round of applause for your 50 to 54 division. Next up, your ladies 45 to 49 division in third place. Fifth appearance here at the CrossFit Games with eight top five finishes by way of CrossFit Forest. Make some noise for Tanya Osborne. I Steve Harvey'd it. That's what they gave me. All right, looks like, right? She would be. Looks like it's going to be Jolaine Undershoot. Fourth appearance here at the CrossFit Games. Out of Endeavor Fitness.
Almost got second. I see that. That was awesome.
And let's try this again in second place. Fifth appearance at the CrossFit Games. Out of CrossFit Forest, Tanya Osborne. And in first place, fifth appearance here at the CrossFit Games with eight top five finishes. Out of CrossFit Byron Bay, Amanda Allen. That is your 45 to 49 division. All right, next up, your 40 to 44 ladies in third place. Second appearance here at the CrossFit Games with five top five finishes. Out of CrossFit Train, Joey Kimden. In second place, her first appearance at the CrossFit Games and seven top five finishes from CrossFit Southampton, Kelly Friel. And on top of the podium, second appearance here at the CrossFit Games and nine top five finishes by way of CrossFit ADM, Stephanie Roy. That is your 40 to 44 women. Next up, your ladies, 35 to 39 women. In third place, second appearance here at the CrossFit Games with seven top five finishes out of CrossFit Solid, Helena Folk. In second place, her first appearance here as a master, six-time individual games athlete, seven top five finishes out of CrossFit Black 5. Really, no need for an introduction. Samantha Briggs! And in first place, first Masters appearance at the CrossFit Games, a five-time CrossFit Games athlete, 9 top 5 finishes out of T2 CrossFit. Give it up for Anna Tobias! One more time for the ladies, your fittest female athletes in the world. All right, men up next, your 60 plus Masters men division. In third place, second appearance here at the CrossFit Games, 5 top 5 finishes, coming by way of Stand Firm CrossFit. Give it up for Cal Charrington.
Thank you very much.
And second place, also his second appearance here at the CrossFit Games, 7 top 5 finishes from Left Coast CrossFit, Armando Garcia Besne. And in first place, his 6th appearance here at the CrossFit Games, 7 top 5 finishes out of CrossFit Solified, David Hippensteel. That is your 60 plus men's division. Next up, 55 to 59 men in third place, 6th appearance here at the CrossFit Games, and 5 top 5 finishes, Will Powell. In second place, second appearance at the games, first place in 2017, 5 top 5 finishes out of CrossFit EGA, Shannon Aiken. And in first place, 5th appearance at the CrossFit Games with 6 top 5 finishes. Make some noise for Brig Edwards. One more time, that's your men's 55 to 59 division. And next up, men's 50 to 54 in third place. 8th appearance here at the CrossFit Games with 4 top 5 finishes. Hustle Hard CrossFit Zone, Mr. Ron Ortiz. In second place, in his 4th appearance at the CrossFit Games, 4 top 5 finishes here this week out of Backcountry CrossFit. Make some noise for Mike Egan. And in first place, 3rd appearance here at the CrossFit Games, 7 top 5 finishes out of CrossFit Utility, Cliff.
Cliff Musgrave. That's your 50 to 54 men. Next up, 45 to 49 men's division. In third place, third appearance here at the CrossFit Games. Six top five finishes this week from CrossFit Fort Vancouver, Nathan Lauren. And in second place, his third appearance here at the CrossFit Games, finishing first in 2015. Seven top five finishes from CrossFit Brisbane, Matthew Swift. And finishing first this year, sixth appearance here at the CrossFit Games, finishing first in 2017. 10 top five finishes this week from CrossFit Bonedale, Robbie Davis. One more round of applause for your 45 to 49 men. Next up, your 40 to 44 men's division. In third place, his rookie appearance here at the CrossFit Games, gathering five top five finishes at a CrossFit Algoa, David Levy. And second place, his fifth appearance here at the CrossFit Games. Six total top five finishes here this week at a CrossFit Arm. Make some noise for Sean Ramirez. And your first place finisher, his second appearance here as a master in our division here, eight top five finishes here. Veteran CrossFit athlete out of CrossFit Extreme Athletics. Give it up for Neil Maddox. Keep it going for your 40 to 44, man, one more time. Last but not least, your 35 to 39 men's division in third place. Second appearance here at the CrossFit Games. Five top five finishes. Soyuz CrossFit Zone, Aris Polkin. In second place, his second appearance as well at the CrossFit Games. Six top five finishes out of CrossFit Zia, Alexander Jolivet. And on top of the podium, second Masters appearance and four games appearances, eight top five finishes, CrossFit Kinesis own Kyle Kasperbauer.
And that is your Masters men, 35-39 podium. And all of your athletes up here, your fittest male Masters in the world. We're going to get all of our Masters athletes for one big photo. Once we get all of our men, ladies, hold on there. And we'll get all of our Masters athletes up here coordinated, smiling for the camera. Stick around, get some photos. Plenty of things going on here around the venue for the rest of the day. I just want to take this opportunity to let each and every one of you know we appreciate all of your support all week long. Thank you guys so much. I know the athletes appreciate it. And all of our staff and volunteers do as well. Our Masters and Teenage Division Dynamite competition all week long. Thank you guys so very much. And we'll see you in 2019.
One, two. One, two. One, two.